Hey guys, I've been sleeping for most of the day, so I'm gonna do the morning reading. Although it's like a lot later in the day. Sorry, not sooner, but later in the day. Psalm 112, verse 7. He shall not fear for evil news. His heart is kind of like still, sort of like it's diligent or still, or like it stands still and trusts in the Lord. Oh yeah. So I figured I should speak a little bit about this thing about my mom and like this thing about her bothering me and this psych ward thing, because this has been bothering me for quite a while now. You know, it doesn't seem to leave me. It doesn't seem to have any end. You know, it seems like this won't leave me. You know, my mom, she gave me a lot of like food, like when I was young, like she gave me a lot of cake and ice cream and you know, bolla and like you know, chocolate cake and all sort of things, and like chocolate and also all these sort of things. And then at one point she asked me to prostitute myself because we were empty. Because we had, we didn't have money anymore, and this is not something I remember very well. This is something I remember. My mom, my dad would always tell me to go to see your mom, and I would go into my mom's room, and she would like dress up in like a sexy underwear and stuff, and she would always go somewhere, you know. She would always go somewhere, and this thing about this psych ward, like. You know, in the news in Norway, you know, I'm kind of famous. So in the news in Norway, they're always saying like, you know, it was because of this treatment method called Pandas. Okay, it's a treatment method called Pandas. It's basically about, you know, it's very hidden behind verse. It's very, you know, hidden behind verse, and the verse is saying like, you know, these people are scared of like bacterial culture and like sort of like that, and you know, it's just hidden. But what this panel method is actually is, it's basically you know, it's basically someone coming and sleeping with these people that are like sort of like sick with this Pandas sickness, you know, Pandas disease, you know. Which is not wrong, which is not the right thing to say. Which is not the right thing to say. Okay, this is basically a lie. Okay, this is basically a lie. Okay, people do not need to be treated by like the Pandas method. They need company. And in my case, I needed to read the Bible. Okay, but I came into the psych ward. I basically ended up doing something really wrong. And it was all because of my mom, okay? Now, the Prime Minister of Norway is also a prostitute, because my mom is a prostitute. And the Prime Minister of Norway is also a prostitute. And she's like, you know, Pandas, that's so good, you know? This guy, he didn't get treated in any way bad by his mom, you know. His mom is like the perfect mom. His mom has done so much right things, you know. His mom has done so much right things, and she's like lashing out against my dad, and she's saying like, your mom is perfect. Your mom did the right thing, you know. And you know. The Prime Minister of Norway has tried to get me, you know, into a relationship with her two daughters, and like get me into a relationship with all the like leaders of the country and like get me into a relationship with like this homosexual leader of the country as well, because she thinks I'm a homosexual. And this is what has always been going on for a while now, okay? This is what has been going on for a while now. My mom asked me to prostitute myself when I was a kid. I did not prostitute myself as when I was a kid, but all of a sudden I had a lot of kids, okay? And I love my kids, but I don't understand like how despicable my mom could possibly become, you know? And she is a prostitute. That means that she is, you know, that probably means that she is a narcissist as well. That she is Jezebel in the demonology language. She's also very dangerous. And you know, this prime minister we have in Norway is also dangerous. This prime minister in Norway has legalized prostitution. She's legalized. She has a lot of like child sex slaves wherever she is. She has a lot of child sex slaves. Okay, she has a lot of child sex slaves. She has a lot of prostitutes. She has a lot of those things. Okay. Because she's obsessed with sex. Because both my mom and the Prime Minister of Norway is obsessed with sex, okay? And that's basically the story of how this happened, okay? How all of this came to be, you know? The Prime Minister of Norway is... The current Prime Minister of Norway was released from a psych ward. And she got... she climbed the ladder. She became a Prime Minister. And she's a prostitute. She is a whore. She is a slut, okay? She's a slut. And she's stupid. And she's ugly as well. So I'm gonna say it like this. You know, my mom, she is not a good woman. The Prime Minister of Norway is not a good woman either. The people that were behind this, they're not good people. They're evil people. And basically, all I needed to do when I was so down was to read this, okay? The Bible. The Bible is what I needed when I was so down, okay? And that's what I did. I read the Bible, but the psych ward decided that I had to have sex, okay? Because they're despicable, because they're evil. And that's the story of how despicable my mom is, how despicable the Prime Minister of Norway is. The police is also into this. If you see all these documentaries on YouTube and other places, you know, you're gonna see that the police has also started like accusing me of all sort of things that I haven't done, all sort of evil things that I haven't done. And like they're always going after me. This is bullshit. This is bullshit. Okay. So the police, the psych ward, my mom, the Prime Minister of Norway, the prostitutes basically. All of the prostitutes, okay? They're going after me, okay? And they're trying to kill me, they're trying to destroy me, okay? You know, the police is also prostitutes, okay? The psych ward is also prostitutes, okay? And that's it, okay? Now, I'm not gonna do some deliverance today, because I figured that should be it. You know, my YouTube feed is full of bullshit. I don't know who is feeding my YouTube shit, YouTube feed, but it's full of bullshit. Okay, it's full of bullshit. And you know, something else my mom has done is probably feeding my brain with shit. You know, she it seems like I'm a test subject for some technology that really shouldn't be in my brain, okay? That really shouldn't be in my brain. So that's the story of what is wrong, and bye-bye.